Some truths are counterintuitive, but they're true nonetheless. If your car skids, then you turn the wheel into the skid to correct it, not away from it. That feels really weird and completely wrong, but it works. You know that clouds are very, very heavy. There they are floating above us. They're really heavy. Even a small cumulus cloud can weigh the same as two elephants. And did you know that if you drop a football and a tennis ball from the same height at the same moment, they will hit the ground at the same time, because gravity exerts a constant pull equally on all objects, however heavy or light they are. You can try this in the garden. If you take a really large stone and a small stone, drop them from the same height at the same moment, they will hit the ground at the same time. Famously, this law of physics, first formulated by Galileo, was put to the test during the 1971 Apollo 15 moon landing by Commander David Scott, who dropped a feather and a hammer at the same time, and this is what happened.
I want to watch this.
Do you have a good picture there? I've got the
beautiful picture, Dave.
Well, in my left hand I have a feather, in my right hand a hammer, and I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago, who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here, and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that?
Which
proves that Mr. Galileo was correct in his findings.
Our gospel reading is packed with counterintuitive truths. First, that society rejects that which it needs most. And if you align yourself with the Son of God, who came to show human society exactly what it needs most, it's likely that you'll be rejected just as he was. Secondly, that the people closest to us, especially our family members, do not always want the best for us, and they are not to claim our first loyalty. And finally, at the end of the gospel reading today, that if you spend your life seeking fulfillment, it will elude you. But if, counterintuitively, you give your life away to God, then you will receive the greatest fulfillment that life can ever offer. It really reminds me of a scene from the Pirates of the Caribbean, actually. I was reading this gospel and I thought of that film. A scene in which up is really down.
Not sunset. Sundown and rise.
Up. What's that? What is that?
I don't know. What do you think?
Where? There.
He's rocking the ship!
kites up into the mast, upside down, so when the boat flips, we'll be the right way up.
Time out from the spell! Loose the cannon! Just do it, Bill Frantz! Unscrew the cargo! Let it serve!
In our New Testament reading, Paul explains that we as Christians, we live in a different world now. That we have in our baptism, that we have been baptized into Christ's death. And that as we go into the waters of baptism, we die with him. And as we come out of the waters of baptism, that we rise with him in his resurrection. A bit like the Pirates of the Caribbean, we die, and then as we die, we are alive in a different world, in a different place. We experience the emotional weather from a different universe, a sun that shines in a different place even when it's raining here. In one of the forms of prayer that I use, there's some beautiful words. It's this: it bids me to be still and aware of God's presence within and all around. Be still and aware of God's presence within and all around. And as I do that, and as you do that, as you pray or read the Bible or worship, then what you're doing is tuning into this different universe that we now exist in, that the core and the heart of us exists in, even while we remain here in this world. We are, when we do those things, beginning to feel the emotional weather from a different universe. And so we respond differently from how we might respond if we were totally caught up here. It makes a difference. Both Jesus and Paul make it clear that we're not to trust blindly traditional wisdom or, or what we've always known, or what everyone knows is true, or even what your parents have told you. Rather, we are meant to constantly test the opinions that have come to us in this way, and indeed been ingrained in us in this way. And this is where it's sometimes difficult to test ourselves and our own opinions, wherever they have come from. We're meant to constantly check them against the gospel values, against the things that Christ teaches and demonstrates in the Gospels. And that when it comes to our opinions and our thoughts and our actions about politics or finances or family life or relationships or priorities, that these are meant to arise not from the values of the culture around us, but from the gospel values that Christ embodies in all that he is.